just wonder if you could help me. Is there a
little girl? Well, you didn't see her. She's just outside. Wouldn't come in. Darndest thing.
But
don't you prefer to sit outside because the woods? What was it now? More scope for the imagination. That was it. She's a case, I should say.
I heard her talking to herself out there.
But I'm not expecting a girl. It's a boy that I have come for. Mrs. Spencer was to bring him over from the asylum for us.
Mrs. Spencer got off the train with that strange sniffer. Gave her into my charge, said you'll be along for her presently. Well, that's all I know about it. I haven't got any more orphans concealed hereabouts.
I don't understand.
Well, I'm sure the girl will be only too happy to tell you every little detail of what happened. She's got a tongue of her own, that's for certain. Good day to you.
I suppose you are Matthew Cuthbert of Green Gables. Well, I'm very glad to see you. I was beginning to be afraid that you weren't coming, and I was imagining all the things that might have happened to prevent you. I'd made up my mind that if you didn't come for me, I'd go down the track to that big wild cherry tree and climb up into it and stay all night. I wouldn't be a bit afraid, and it would be lovely to sleep on a tree all white with bloom and the moonshine, don't you think? I can also imagine that I'm already a disappointment to you. I'm aware that I'm not much to look at, but even though I'm thin, I'm very strong. I want you to know that I'm forever grateful that you're adopting me. You're a sight for sore eyes, Mr. Cuthbert.
You best come along. I'll take your bag.
Oh, I can carry it. It isn't heavy. I've got all my worldly goods in it, but it isn't heavy. And if it isn't carried a certain way, it falls right open, so I better keep it. I've come to know the exact knack of it.